today's episode, I have Nick and Janet, who are really good friends of ours as a family. They're part of our church family at Resound, and they're both amazing spirit-filled people who we journey with. They carry so much of God and of the prophetic, and I just thought it'd be really awesome to hear their hearts today, because they carry such a lot of God, carry lots of wisdom and experience and all sorts. So guys, welcome. Thank you for being willing to be on this with me. And do you want to just kick off by just saying kind of a little bit about what you guys do and who you are? That'd be great.
I'm Nick, married to Janet, and we've got three daughters, and we've got three grandchildren and another one on the way. We live in Bristol. We moved from near Guildford about 30 years ago. We were going to be here for 1 year, and we're still here. We really love it here. I work for the NHS in the middle of town. I used to work as a children's nurse, and now I work in information technology. And as you can probably be aware, we're very busy at the moment with the current issues that are happening.
At the moment, I'm focusing very much on supporting our family. I'm also co-founder of a charity called Parent Buddies, and we're currently having a bit of a pause on that just while we think about ways we can move forward in this current climate.
So you were saying about how things have kind of looked very different, increased pressure at work, particularly Nick. And so for both of you, with life looking really different, how are you finding it kind of adapting to, you know, day to day?
I think it's finding a different rhythm, but actually having a rhythm is really essential. So for me, most of my time I'm working from home. I have to be flexible because of the urgent requirements that are needed. I think it's learning a different rhythm, but also learning how to use different ways of communicating with people and making intentional times to chat or meet up in different formats apart from face-to-face.
And for me, it's more about a time of personal challenge, actually, because I'm the kind of person who's usually extremely busy, helping other people, doing everything for everyone else. And actually, even before we went to lockdown, God was actually speaking to me about rest and about finding a different place of being still and being able to listen to God more, which, to be honest, if I'm honest, I'm quite resistant to that because of just my personality. And so it is a challenge. It's a daily challenge. Sometimes I'm just restless, and other times I can connect with God, and it's just God's teaching me so much in this time. It's kind of a bit mind-blowing, the kind of stuff that I'm hearing from God and that he's doing really deep in me. So this seems to be a time of quite deep kind of inner healing. Actually,
it's amazing. And I think, you know, there's so many stories of how how God's just pursuing more freedom over people during this time, when, you know, when our default is to kind of feel really flustered and not quite sure where to go with this all, or how to hold it, or how to think about it. But I think, you know, this is a kind of like magnified version of what a lot of people go through day to day, which is challenges, you know, and how we find God in the midst of our kind of daily challenges and life's challenges. And you guys are involved in the kind of prophetic side of Resound, and you've run courses to help activate people and equip people in hearing from God. So do you want to tell us a little bit about that?
What is on my heart is to see people be enabled to hearing God for themselves. And I think the crux of the matter is actually spending time and quietness and listening to God in different ways. And I think that it's enabling people to slow down and just take time out of busy schedule. So even though we may have a period of lockdown at the moment, people can still be very busy doing lots of different things around the house or the garden, for example. But actually, it's about taking time out intentionally. And I think we ran a few courses over the last year and a half, and most of it was practical experiences of slowing down and quietening the soul to hearing God in different ways. And what really excites me most is when you have a group of people who are following God, who may have either lost touch of hearing God's still voice or have never really experienced it, seeing them come alive when they hear God speaking to them through pictures, through words, through music, through the natural beauty that's all around us. And my heart is to see everybody inside and outside the church to be able to hear God in a fresh way and see how that energizes them and gives them purpose and gives them a mission and gives them destiny, because they're hearing their Father's voice. And that gives me such a buzz to see people being set free to hear God for themselves.
Yeah, and I just want to add, really, just personally, just doing this, having groups in our home week after week, I'm learning, I'm growing, I'm maturing in the prophetic, and it's been brilliant to see others and myself just growing and maturing in their prophetic gifting and actually understanding, yeah, God can speak to me, and actually I can hear God for myself and for others, and just even just tuning into God, you know, on an everyday normal basis, they're learning and kind of just speaking out and starting to encourage others. And I think if you look at the bigger picture, I think within our church, our local church, we have seen an increase of people being more bold and more brave about getting up and saying something they thought might God be speaking and just telling their stories. So it's just brilliant, and it really blesses my heart. It just is so encouraging to see that growing and God just bringing us all to a deeper place with Him.
Well, that's good. Do you guys have a particular story, maybe, of somebody who came on one of, you know, your courses, or someone that you know who suddenly kind of heard from God for the first time, or, you know, had an increase of awareness?
Yeah. Yes, I can. I'm thinking of a group that came, and this person came, a guy came, and told us at the beginning he doesn't really hear from God at all. And so we do an exercise where we have different pictures on postcards, and they choose one and they sit down and they reflect on it and ask God to say something. And so as we'd done the exercise, I was drawing the group together, back together, and this person said, wait a minute, I must share something. And then in front of him was a picture which he spent the next 5 minutes explaining what God was saying to him about it. And in fact, that picture and what he said was part of the way ahead for him and his family. And so it was very significant for them.
The story I'm thinking about was when we had to cancel the group one evening, the story we got back from one of the group the next week was that he felt a little nudge to go into Bath that evening because he'd had a spare evening, and he ended up basically preaching the gospel to a homeless guy. It was just the most extraordinary story, and you know, he doesn't know the outcome of that, but we were just so encouraged that he was, you know, he hadn't ever done anything like that before. He said, I don't even quite know why, but I just had this little tiny little inkling that I should go to Bath, so I did. And it was completely out of the blue, and this guy ended up stopping him and asking him a question, and then he started pouring out his heart to him, and then this guy from the group was able to kind of really witness to him and about, you know, God being his, God loving him and being faithful to him in extreme circumstances. So that was encouraging. to see people stepping outside of their normal kind of, yeah, just a little bit out of the normal.
How would you encourage people then to kind of, either those who feel they've never heard from God or those who kind of hear from him a bit, or maybe don't have confidence? What kind of encouragement could you share for those watching?
Spending time on reflecting and seeking God. And one of the first things we have to do is actually quieten our body down. So one of the most difficult exercises, a practical exercise, which sometimes I call homework, which we did each week, one of them was called Take Five. And that is, take 5 minutes out, just sitting there quietly, deep breathing, turning off any distractions, and just being. And if you can't start with 5 minutes, just go for 1 minute, because it's actually when we start slowing down the busyness of life that I really feel God saying, finally, you're actually quietening down, Nick. Mm-hmm. I really want to share lots of things with you. Mm-hmm. And I think it's being intentional in a rhythm to be able to do that is one of the simplest exercises.
And another thing I'd add, I think, is just ask God. Keep asking. Just every day, say, God, can you speak to me today? I have lots of dreams. And I think dreams can be very powerful, and God can really speak through our dreams. And one of the things that I sometimes do intentionally is ask God as I go to sleep, God, can you speak to me, you know, in my sleep? And more often than not, if I actually pray that prayer and speak to God like that before I go to sleep, I have quite an interesting dream. And quite often it's something to do with me and life processing, but it could be huge. It could be something else. It could be like a big prophetic picture. It could be something for the church or wider. Really what we've been doing is something on a very small scale and quite a basic level, but it's kind of surprised us how many people say, well, I don't hear from God. It really shocks us to realize actually there's so many people that say, well, how do you then? And they don't know. And it's, so I think what we've done is kind of started something that just nudges people onto the next level and the next level. And we certainly haven't got there. We're still searching. We're still wanting to kind of, you know, move on in our own, you know, sort of prophetic anointing or gifting. But we're really encouraged by what we see. And that is one of our giftings as a couple, that we're encouragers. And we just want to pass it on. We want to pass it on to other people.
I think another thing is to actually open our eyes more. And I think that the word, the prophetic, can just have a very blinkered view on what we see. And I think helping people to look around and open their eyes and see what's around, like, for example, what about the picture behind me? What about the bookcase or even the lampshade? God wants to share his heart, not just through scripture or words or pictures, but everything around us. And I think as we learn how to do that, God shows us more and more.
So at the moment then, guys, what has God been speaking to you about specifically that would be encouraging to share with those watching?
God's been enabling me to be far more creative than I have in the past. And I enjoy writing poetry, and I've started emailing that to people in the church and at work. And I think that God is using that in a prophetic way as encouraging others. And it makes me smile on a couple of points. That firstly, it is an encourager to people who read it. But also, I was not very good at all at English. as when I was younger, and God is redeeming that. So that's really encouraged me as well as encouraging others. And also, I think at this time, one of the most powerful things that we can do for people around us is listen, and hear what they're saying in their hearts. Because like you mentioned earlier, Matt, this time is a time of intensifying lots of things. It's bringing up a lot of things for people that have been there all the time. And I think one of the restoring ways that we can help is listen to people. They need to be heard.
So for me, I guess it's more a personal thing that's happening for me at the moment. We've got a summer house in the garden, which is my place to go, my quiet place. And yeah, I think God's saying, keep saying, come here, come deeper. He's saying, come deeper to me, and I'm trying to respond in that.
So kind of finding your Gethsemane type place.
Yeah.
And I think that's really encouraging as well for all of us to really find a place where we can settle and be still. However hard that is with children, you know, I find that particularly difficult, having two young children to have that time of just quiet and peace. But actually it's really important that we do that, and Jesus models it so well, doesn't he? When he goes to the Garden of Gethsemane just to be with his Father. So I think there's something really powerful about that. So yeah, that's awesome. So do you guys want to finish then maybe by chucking out one of the exercises you do for the your Hearing from God course, just so people can, you know, go away with something to practice or to give it a go and to hear from God for themselves?
Okay, so this is an exercise you can do very simple at home, a listening to God exercise. If you're isolating at home with family or friends, get one person in your family to give you two personal objects. So it could be, I don't know, a phone, keys, a piece of clothing, an object that belongs to them. Get them to give them to you. And what you need to do is just simply ask God to speak about your friend or your other person through the objects. Just literally look at the objects and just go with whatever comes. It could be something you see, it could become something you sense, it could be a train of thought or a scripture. Whatever comes when you look is probably from God, okay? It's not like super spiritual, this thing. This is literally about being practical and tuning in and just saying, hey God, I'm offering myself up to you right now for this person. I want to bless them and encourage this person. Could you speak to me? And that's as simple as that. So that's one exercise you can do. If you're isolating at home on your own, this is another thing you can do for yourself. Maybe go into choose one of your rooms in your house. It could be your lounge, it could be your kitchen, and just sit, stand in the room. Just have a stop and be still for a minute, look around and ask God to highlight something, an object or something that you can see or smell or hear in your kitchen or your room that you've chosen. And just ask God, does he want to speak to you about anything in your life? And just wait and see what you get. That's another simple exercise you can do for yourself.
And to add to that is actually, when something does resonate and comes back and you hearing God's words for you, is actually go back and ask God more questions about it and go for a deeper understanding, because it's a dialogue with God and he wants to spend time with you and he wants to show you more things, and you might not hear it the first time. Keep going.
So guys, thank you so much for your time today. And thank you for your honesty with how things are for you at the moment, but also your encouragement of how we can hear from God more, and just giving things a go. And I think what's amazing about you both is you just pursue God's heart for other people, and you want to see people released in freedom to hear for themselves. And it's really, you know, great encouragement to so many people. So thank you for sharing those things. And Nick, thank you so much for all you're doing for, you know, within the NHS. And I know so many people are, you know, really proud of our kind of frontline workers at the moment. So I just wanted to acknowledge that and say thank you for you know, everything that you're doing personally and your team and department for the NHS at this time. So yeah, guys, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks for inviting us.
Thank you. Bye-bye.